February 4th, 2022. Let's take a quick peek at my 2001 Mustang Bullitt. This is a no accident, two owner car, Florida driven its whole life, garaged its entire life, accident free, original paint, original clear coat. Really, I've restored and had 30 cars over the past 35 years that I've again restored or fixed up. And the only thing I've done to this is just put in new coils, plugs, filters, gaskets, tires, hood cowl, headlights, third brake light on the top, a full clutch, the pinion seal, U-joint, anything that was showing any signs of wear whatsoever has been done. Motor Trend magazine tested this car in original OEM condition in 2001. They tested it 0 to 60 in 5.1 seconds. And I don't think it's lost a step. It's a very, very quick car. Quasi traction, lower than the regular GT because it's the Bullitt version. Special Bullitt markings, special solid aluminum wheels, 17-inch wheels, original to the car. Dual caliper front disc brakes with the laser etched Mustang on the back. Right now this is blocking it, but laser etched Mustang's on the back there. Other unique features for the Bullitt versus the GT is this back window. The shape of the back window is different. Obviously the Bullitt marking on the sill here. The Bullitt seats, these are original seats. These are factory replacement Bullitt mats. It's a 5-speed standard transmission. It's got the only upgrade you could get on this car was the Mach 1 stereo system with CD player. It's got the polished aluminum pedals. And here's a look at the seat. Really incredible seats, very comfortable, even for a big guy like me. I'm 6'4". Fit comfortably in this car. The original ball, 5-speed ball. This is the traction control feature. I've kept the traction control on at all times, but to shut it off, you just push the button. AC is ice cold. Stereo. The interior is just about perfect. Headliner and everything. Rear seats never been sat in. I bought it from a friend who bought it new. And Her name is Joan. She's in her mid-70s now. I just bought it from her. She bought it new, like I said. Took very good care of it. Other small things, they clear coated inside the factory clear coat inside the engine bay, which they didn't do on a regular GT. This is the air intake system right here. This is an original factory marking. This has got 57 millimeter ports. So it's 114 millimeters, it's more than 4 inches of air intake. This is a special intake designed for the Mustang Bullitt. Those familiar with the car, there's a hologram here. It's a three-layer hologram with a number of the bullet. The same hologram is underneath the rear seat of the car. This is the original hood blanket. Reproductions do not have the pony on it. So this is the original hood blanket. And again, all clear coated, factory clear coat inside. Obviously kept in really good condition. The Ford design team spent a lot of money in art research in 1999 through 2001 on the 3-inch exhaust. This is 3-inch stainless steel tips, but you can't really hear the exhaust. You can hear it a little bit, but this, you know, phones don't pick up the exhaust sound very well. But it's a beautiful sound. It's made to simulate McQueen's car in the 1968 movie, and it really does simulate that noise. So, just a really quick tour around the body, just so you can see that there's no dents or dings. There's a little bruise on the front bumper, right here, that I repaired. I didn't want to paint it. The sides of the car are pretty much pristine. Again, this is a Florida car, always garaged. I think it's really rare for this car to have, this is a little bit of dust. It's really rare for this car to have real nice clear coat. So, that's a quick look at my 2001 Mustang Bullitt, two-owner, accident-free, original paint car.